Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been buried with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection. On the day of baptism, you put on Christ. On the day of Christ's coming, may you be clothed with glory. Amen. The gospel, the good news of salvation, has been your rule and guide during your life. May it now assist you in your journey to the fulfillment of salvation, which is so much desired. Amen. Let us pray. Father, hear our prayers and be merciful to your servant, Crispin Yomi Ogunseye, whom you have called from this life. Welcome him to the company of your saints in the kingdom of light and peace, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. O God Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant, Crispin Yomi Ogunseye, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and no torment will ever touch them. In the eyes of the foolish, they seem to have died, and their departure was thought to be an affliction, and their going from us to be their destruction. But they are at peace. For though in the sight of men they were punished, their hope is full of immortality. Having been disciplined a little, they will receive great good, because God tested them and found them worthy of himself. Like gold in the furnace, he tried them, and like a sacrificial burnt offering, he accepted them. In the time of their visitation, they will shine forth and will run like sparks through the stubble. They will govern nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord will reign over them forever. Those who trust in him will understand truth, and the faithful will abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are upon his elect. The word of the Lord. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, no evil would I fear, for you are with me.
Shadow of death, no evil would I fear, for you are with me. He guides me along the right path. He's true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil will I fear. With this you give me comfort.
Shadow of death, no evil will I fear, for you are with me. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brethren, none of us lives to himself, and none of us dies to himself. If we live to the Lord, and if we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord of the dead and of the living. We shall all stand before the judgment seat of God, for it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So, each of us shall give account of himself to God. The word of the Lord. May we all stand.
Resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me shall never die. Lord. Sing,
sing hallelujah to the Lord.
Sing hallelujah to the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Sing hallelujah to the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. At that time, Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. And even now I know that whatever you ask from God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." Martha said to him, "I know that he will rise again in the resurrection at the last day." Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, he who is coming into the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
There is a poem by one Henry Van Dyke, which I have edited and which describes to me what death is like. And this poem goes like this. Imagine yourself standing on a seashore. Imagine that a ship at your side spreads her white sails to the morning breeze and starts out for the blue ocean. This ship is a beautiful one, and very huge in strength. And you stand and watch her until at length she's only a ribbon of white cloud just above where sea and sky mingle with each other. Then someone at your side says, "There. She's gone." "Gone where?" "Gone from our sight." That is all. Yes, because She is just as large in mast and hull and spar as she was when she left your side, and just as able to bear her load of living freight to the place of destination. Her diminished size is in our sight and in us on this side of the shore, not in her. And just at the moment when someone at your side says, there, she's gone, there are other voices ready to take the glad shout, there she comes. At the other side of the shore where the ship baits. My dear brothers and sisters and dear friends, and that is what dying and death is all about for those who believe and trust in Jesus and in God. It is a passage to the other world, the world of God. That is exactly, my dear brothers and sisters, what has happened to our husband, our father, and our friend, Crimson Ogunseye. And that is why I title this homily, Gone, Only From Our Sight, Into the World of God, the Saints, and the Angels. He is only gone from our sight. The first reading today is one which we have heard so often about the souls of the virtuous. The book of Wisdom, chapter 3, from verse 1 to verse 9. That reading should call to our mind how God loves those who believe in him. That reading should calm our fears about death, especially for those who trust in God. It says, the souls of the virtuous are in the hands of God, and no harm can ever touch them. Wisdom, chapter 3, verse 1. What better place, my dear brothers and sisters, could we go after death than into the hands of God? What a beautiful way to describe God's care for all of us. If you remember, when you were small and your parents took you up in their arms, the author of the reading says, for those who believe in God, when they die, God takes them up in his hands. Yes, as we pray for Crimson today, we believe that God has taken him up in his hands, even as he is gone from our sight. And the reading continues, to someone without faith, they did appear to die, but that is not the case at all. Someone with faith would rather say, as the reading says, they are in peace. They merely appeared to die. Their going was only like a disaster. Their leaving us was only like an annihilation. Wisdom, chapter 3, from verse 2 to verse 3. In other words, they did not die. They only appeared to die. Their leaving us was not a disaster or annihilation. It only seemed that way. The passage ends beautifully, expressing the faith of someone who believes in God's goodness and who therefore is not afraid to die. The final line of this first reading, my dear brothers and sisters, is quite instructive to all of us. It gives us another reason for not fearing death. Grace and mercy await those he has chosen. Wisdom, chapter 3, verse 9. It is grace and mercy that we will receive from God. Anything else that we will receive in the next life is of our own making, not God's making. That is why each and every one of us should do good while we are still alive. We should show love to others as we live our lives here on earth. And we should live good lives. And we have time to repent and reform before death. It is grace and mercy that God wants to give us. So we ask God to take Crimson up in his arms, to pour his love, grace, and mercy upon him through Christ our Lord. In the gospel reading today, John chapter 11, verse 21 to 27, we are presented with an example of a life of faith. It is also an example of our faith being strong and being faithful and true in the face of death. When in the death of a loved one, we are comforted and lifted up by the message of Christ today. For in death, the love of God becomes intense and complete. This, my dear brothers and sisters, applies to our friend Crimson Ogunseye and all our diseased, and even to all of us. When this earthly life comes to an end in death, for Jesus did not abolish physical and bodily death, but rather overcame it and all its powers and raised us to a new and eternal life. According to St. Paul, in his first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 15, from verse 50 to verse 57, for the trumpet will sound, the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. The perishable must clothe itself with the imperishable. Martha, my dear brothers and sisters, was guided and accompanied by this total faith in God in the hour of her deep sorrow and pain for the death of her brother Lazarus in the gospel reading today. With and in this faith, Martha was able to overcome the dark hours of her grief and pain by placing her hope in Jesus Christ. For all those then who live with this type of faith in the Lord and in the resurrection, whether they live or whether they die, they belong to the Lord. St. Paul tells us in the second reading today, Romans chapter 14, verse 7, if we live, we live for the Lord. If we die, we die to the Lord. Whether we live or die, we belong to the Lord. It is not so much important how life here on earth ends, how we die, nor is it a question of overcoming physical and material bodily death. The faith in Jesus Christ gives a new dimension, a new direction, and a new meaning to our life and our death, and in fact, gives it a new orientation. Our faith in Jesus Christ makes the dark moments and hours of our life bright, because Jesus is the resurrection and the life. We will not die because we believe in him, because he says, anyone who believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And so today, with this faith in Jesus Christ, in his cross and in his resurrection, we are comforted and lifted up. And like Martha, we trust in Jesus' word when Jesus says, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me will live, even if he or she dies. Let us, my dear brothers and sisters, therefore, in the hope and in the same faith in the resurrection, comfort each other as we bid farewell to our husband, our father, and our friend, Crispin Ogunseye, today. What can we actually say about the man, Crispin Ogunseye, as friends and family, as we pay him our last respect today? Crispin was a man of great faith who accepted life the way it came and resigned himself to whatever came as the will of God after he had done all that is humanly possible. I say this for one reason, because I remember on the day he marked his 70th birthday, not too long ago, on that day, Professor Bolaji Akinyemi, a former Minister of Foreign Affairs, who was a very good friend of his, told a story of how Crispin almost became Nigeria's ambassador to Italy, only but for just one signature. When this happened, Crispin never killed himself. He never killed anybody. He did not blame it on any witchcraft, but he accepted it and continued to live on and lived a long life thereafter, at least more than 20 years after the incident. Crispin was a man of faith who remained faithful to the end. Secondly, Crispin was a man who cared about others. I remember one fateful day early last year or thereabout, he called me on the telephone and he said to me, "Father, I want you to say masses for my very good friend, a military man who had a fatal accident." He said, "I believe there is nothing God cannot do. I want him to get well again." Yes, he was one who cared about others. One of the great problems, my dear brothers and sisters, we have in our world today is the lack of care for others and lack of concern about others. Is it not true that life would have been better for many in our country today if we care about each other more, irrespective of tribe, religion, class, or association? Our world would have been a happier place if we share love and care with all those around us. Is it not true that while many wallow in poverty and lack around us, others brood in shameless wealth and luxury and in reckless disregard for the poor and the needy around them? My dear brothers and sisters, friends, family, as we bid farewell and commit our friend into God's merciful hand, we are aware that he might have had his shortcomings and weaknesses like any one of us. After all, no one is perfect, only God is. We pray that God may forgive him, grant him a merciful judgment, and accept his soul into paradise. I conclude this homily with this prayer for Crispin. May Christ, who called you at your baptism, lead you to paradise. May Christ, who was crucified and died for your sake, deliver you from eternal death. May Christ, Son of the living God, set you down in the fresh beauty of his paradise, and may he, the good shepherd, claim you as one of his flock. May he forgive you all your sins and grant you a place among the saints at his own right hand. There, may you ever behold your Redeemer face to face, because your Redeemer lives. And may you ever stand before him and place in the ranks of the blessed. May you delight in the vision of God forever and ever. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May the soul of Crispin and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. From all of us, Crispin, Ogunseye, we say, Resquare cat in pace.
Let us stand for the prayer of the faithful. Let us pray with faith and confidence to God our Father, who raised his Son, Jesus Christ, from death, that he may give comfort to the living and eternal rest to the dead.
May our brother, Christian Yomi Ogunseye, who received the grace of baptism, reap his full fruits as he enjoys the vision of God in the happiness of eternal life. We pray, O Lord. For the forgiveness of sin. As we remember with love and affection the life of our departed brother, Crispin Ogunseye, may he always be in our prayers as we ask God's mercy to forgive his sins. We pray, O Lord. For the church ministers, that they may continue to proclaim in season and out of season the saving power of Christ's resurrection, by which we are raised from the dead of sin to the new life of grace. We pray, O Lord. Those who are left to mourn their loss, may they be thinking today not of the darkness of death, but of the brightness of the resurrection, that of the day when they will meet again, their brother Christian, whom they have lost a while. We pray, O Lord. For the grace of a happy death. May the faith of our beloved brother inspire us for the rest of our days, so that we may remain true to the faith which has been handed on to us. We pray, O Lord. Pray with Mary, Mother of the risen Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners. In the silence of our minds and hearts, we pray for our own needs, to our loving Father.
Let us pray. Father, because you are the lover of life in whom there is no darkness or death, we make our prayers confident that you will answer them through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. And sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise
and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you this sacrificial offering, so Lord, for the salvation of your servant Crispin Ogunseye, we beseech your mercy that he, who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord. Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has done that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions and for the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you wish to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect. especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Alfred Martins, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Crispin Ogunseye, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
It is time for the reception of Holy Communion. The grace of this Holy Mass is for everyone present, but Holy Communion is reserved for baptized and practicing Catholics who have prepared themselves to receive the Lord. We acknowledge in our midst our sisters and brothers of other religious denominations who have come to worship with us. We kindly request that you remain on your seats and pray along with the church. God bless us all. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our brother, Crispin Ogunseye, may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the offertory collection.
Father's house, there are many mansions there. In my Father's house, in my Father's house, in my Father's house, there are many mansions there. In my Father's house above. In my Father's house, in my Father's house, there are many mansions there. In my Father's house above, happy we shall be. Oh.
fructus fructus ventris ventris tui Jesus. Ave Maria.
Glory to Jesus. At this point, we will have a thanksgiving. So we invite the Ogunseye family, friends and well-wishers to come forward and thank God. Choir, we sing.
Thank you.
To Jesus. So at this point, we invite a representative of the family to address us briefly, please. Glory to Jesus. On behalf of the Ogunseye family, we want to say a very big thank you to all of you for finding the time to come this morning to celebrate our brother, our father, uncle, cousin, and friend. We lack words at this time to say how appreciative we are for your prayers, for your kind words, for your thoughts, and everything you have done since the passing of our son. After the final commendation, we're going to have food that will be distributed at the exit. We are using all the four exits of the church, the two side doors on the left of my side and on the right of my side. So as you go out, there's a pack that you take with you. Please, as you take that pack, we expect you to prayerfully leave the church and go back to your places of work or to your various homes. Because the burial site where we are going to enter Mr. Ogunseye has given a specific number of persons that they will allow into their premises. And that number is very, very limited. And so if your name is not on that list, there's no need for you to bother to go to the cemetery. So please just take your pack and prayerfully go back to your places of work or to your homes. Thank you so very much. And may the good Lord continue to bless you through Christ our Lord. Thank you.
Monsignor and Father, the Ogunseye family, brothers and sisters, the Archbishop again sends his condolences to the Ogunseye family, and he has graciously sent Father Philip Susumobi to represent him at this occasion. He would have been here himself. So Father Philip is here representing the Archbishop. Thank you. Any priest who has worked in Falomo and any priest who has celebrated masses regularly here will be able to come out with the map of the sitting arrangement of regular worshippers in this parish. In fact, you can take them according to the masses, and the arrangement will just be like you are having a football team and you have put the different players in their positions for the 6 o'clock or 6:15 mass on Sunday, 7:30, 9, and 11, following the regular Sunday mass schedule. Any priest will be able to tell. And so you have, you know, those who are the strikers in Falomo, they sit in front. Then you have the wingers, they sit by the sides. You have the midfielders, then you have the defenders. And so how will it look like by the time we come back again as a family after this COVID, and we take our regular sitting positions on Sunday, and the one who plays central defense is not there? Will we be able to manage with the situation? But that is the reality that we have found ourselves today. Now, God has called the central defender, not only of the backbenchers, but of the entire parish. God has called him to give an account of himself. Well, that is, we accept it as God's will. And we continue to pray that the prayers we offer for the happy repose of the soul, we find favor in God's sight through Christ our Lord. We know it's not an easy one to bear, but it's in when then to cause, as our teaching tells us, life is changed, not ended. So he has gone ahead of us. And we believe that because he died believing in Christ, he's going to see God face to face in heaven and intercede for us, hoping and waiting for that particular day when we unite with him and rejoice with God forever. And so to Mrs. Yetunde Ogunseye, whom he has left behind, we pray God to give you the grace to bear with this loss of your dear husband. Pray God to grant you fortitude during this period. Pray God to give you the strength to cope with this period of mourning. But we are praying that you will come out through this period of mourning and continue with the life God has called you to live. And to other members of the relatives present here, we pray God also to strengthen you as you mourn your brother and husband and uncle. We pray God to be with you during this period of your mourning. We are praying God that his departure will unite your family. We strengthen that bond through Christ our Lord. And then for the members of the backbenchers, God has called a strong member of your team. Let this not divide you. You are a strong force here in this parish in so many ways. but rather let his going be a source of strength and more unity among you. No, praying that he will always be in heaven to rejoice with God forever. And to the entire parishioners of Church of Assumption, this is a big loss, really. But we thank God for all what has happened. I pray God to grant you all strength and courage to bear with this loss through Christ our Lord. You know, at this point, we are not saying goodbye to Chairman, but we are saying that we hope to see you one day in heaven through Christ our Lord. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May the soul of Crispin Ogunseye and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. So we now have the final commendation ceremony. Please stand.
We have page 13. With faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of our brother Crispin Yomi Ogunseye to be buried in human imperfection. Let us pray with confidence to God, who gives life to all things, that he will raise up this mortal body to the perfection and company of the saints. May God give him merciful judgment and forgive all his sins. May Christ the Good Shepherd lead him safely home to be at peace with God our Father. And may he be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of the eternal King. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father,
our Father,
our response is, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Respond.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to his aid. Come to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to Abraham's side. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Your response is, Lord, save your people.
Lord, save your people.
By your coming as man, by your birth,
Lord, save your people.
By your baptism and fasting,
Lord, save your people.
by your sufferings and cross,
Lord, save your people.
By your death and burial,
Lord, save your people.
By your rising to new life,
Lord, save your people.
By your return in glory to the Father,
Lord, save your people.
By your gift of the Holy Spirit,
Lord, save your people.
By your coming again in glory,
Lord, save your people.
Father, into your hands we commend the servant Crispin Yomi Ogunseye. We have confidence that with all who have died in Christ, he will be raised to life on the last day and live with Christ forever. Lord, hear our prayer, welcome our father into paradise, and help us to comfort each other with the assurance of our faith. We thank you for the blessings you gave him in this life, to show your fatherly care for all of us and fellowship which is ours with the saints in Jesus Christ. And we all meet in Christ to be with you and with our Father forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the angel conduct you into paradise. May the martyrs receive you at their coming and lead you into the holy city of Jerusalem. May the choir of angels receive you, and may you have eternal rest with Lazarus, who was formerly poor. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord.
And let the perpetual light shine upon him.
May he rest in peace.
Amen.
May his soul and the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.